fate has smiled on these teams once, which team will catch your eye again in this second round matchup between the Jacksonville Dolphins and the Princeton Tigers? Dick, you've been in this situation as a coach. What do you tell your team when it looks like a mismatch on paper?
I tell you what, it looks like a David versus Goliath, baby, but you never know. Could be upset city if they protect the basketball. You know what? I think it's essential they control the tempo of the game.
The Tigers are definitely going to have to fight to keep up in this one, Dick. What's the key to their success tonight?
I would say that these are the keys tonight. Number one, control the tempo of the game. I look for the point guard to be the floor general out there. Next, be strong with the ball. Turnovers can be the story here tonight, so protect that basketball. Thirdly, get your man on your hip after the shot. Block out and get after those boards.
Well, partner, I say let's get to the action on the court and we'll see how this one plays out.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, they're really doing a great job packing it in, then a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Showing maturity by waiting for the O to regroup.
High post screen. So effective, that screen.
He gets it to go.
Inside.
Number four receives the pass. Fakes a jumper. He shoots from left of the circle. Way off target. He keeps his dribble as they reset. Dickey's still applying great pressure on the dribbler. Dick, I think there's a mismatch in the post.
It's definitely a mismatch.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He missed the jumper off the nice screen.
They go into the low block. Tries to turn, the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play to stop that spin move.
Patience with the ball as the offense regroups. Now trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two. Doesn't go. Number 45 receives the ball.
He kept the ball on the floor and waited for his teammate to set that screen for the sweet jumper. Boy, that was beautiful.
Number 10 is whistled for the foul. First team foul. Down inside. Tries for two. Can't get the shot to drop. He stays in control until they regroup the offense. They'll work it around the arc. Great steal. I think the pressure was just too much.
Tremendous pressure. Just enough to force the steal.
Perfectly executed. In. He can't stay with him.
He's got to get some help from his teammates on D.
Dickey's really sticking to his man. He swatted everything out of the air,
including the other player.
And the slam.
Take a look right here. He explodes to the basket.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Ball was knocked loose, but the offense got it back. And our trifecta for the night. Aaron Andrews on the sideline. With Dick Vitale. I'm Brad Nessler. Nice to have you along with us. Number 45 handles the feed. Number 10 pump fakes. The shooting guard handles the pass. The skip pass is picked off.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. That's even more important on how talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. That's just great hustle and great defense with a steal.
I tell you what, they telegraphed that pass, and he read it perfectly defensively as a post player.
Nicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense...
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with the block shot.
High post flashes. He takes it away. And again, they look to run. Jumps in. Too much contact there and knocked him off balance a little.
Trying to go inside.
And they do. They got on the low block. They're working around the perimeter. Trying to draw the foul. Number one with a finger roll. Moving it around the perimeter. Those long arms trying to get it in front three quarters.
I'll tell you one thing, that big guy down inside, though, is so big that really it's tough to deny him the ball.
For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
That's an 8-0 run. Tempo of the game really important here. You want to establish some good tempo.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
Shoots it off the rim and no good. Trying to feed the low block. And he tries to spin away from the defender.
I tell you, he's versatile in the post. He's got the spin move and a number of other activities.
The Dolphins have a mismatch in the post.
This may be a good opportunity for them, Brad.
Kicks it out. From downtown. Questionable shot selection there.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
On the dribble, gives it up. He fires it up. Way off target. Good job defensively. Fast break opportunity here.
My goodness. Players these days in their athleticism basically jumping up in the air and then deciding what they're going to do. I'll tell you, it must be nice.
For the bucket, knocks it down. There appears to be a mismatch in the post.
They need to get him the ball there.
There's a bad pass right to the defender. Here we go on the break. They work the perimeter. Boy, terrible execution on offense. Gave it up. He puts up the three ball. Gets it to go.
There he is. Puts the ball loose. There's a steal.
Goes up for two. And he scores despite the hack. There's the fake. He goes with a baby hook.
They let him get into a rhythm.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
there's a double team waiting there. They work it back to the outside. He makes the block. Let's go to the third member of our broadcast team. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Brad, although the underdog holds the lead now, remember, it is very early, and we don't know if they have been in this position before. So we'll have to see if they'll be able to maintain it.
All right, thanks, Aaron. On the dribble, gives it up. Here's a drop step and a low block.
Very key is to get good post position, and he does, and then he drops the step.
Runs him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offense.
Gets up to make the block. Off the rim and no good. He intercepts it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
He strips him clean. Here they go into transition. They are heating up this building where they're shooting right now, Dick.
The hits just keep coming, baby.
Dump it inside.
From right at the circle.
He got off the nice shot off the dribble by running the defender into that solid screen.
The three ball.
Nice high post screen.
Time to pick up the defense here now. Vicky's working on that low block on that right hip.
I'll tell you one thing, he's trying to deny him the ball initially, but the defense really doesn't do a great job of sealing them off.
And now he's got a little something for the crowd. They're not gonna like this. They're gonna be offended.
You've got that right, Brad.
The Dolphins go to the line for the first time in this game. Makes the first shot. He hits the second. Makes the third. There's a lazy pass. It's stolen away. Turnover. Will it turn into two the other way? Looking for a good shot. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
With the free throw. First shot. Good.
Makes those free throws count. He wants to go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Fakes the shot. You see it time and time again. Star players make plays.
Hey, Brad, he's what I call a PTP, a prime time player. When the spotlight is on, he usually performs. Spacing.
Jumps into the defender. In and out.
I'll tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
The Tigers have a mismatch in the post.
Can they get him the ball, though?
The Tigers are a stop away from hearing this crowd go senseless. And a momentary look from three-point land. It sticks. You better plug your ears if they get a basket on this possession. Dickie's doing a nice job defensively fronting it.
Well, it's the key is to really beat him to the spot, get help from the help side, and really do a great job seeing ball in there.
him in the low block, but opted against it. And Dick, this is just playing good defense.
Really does a great job with his footwork, beating him to the spot.
The ball goes out of play. He's got a high post flasher.
Oh, poor job. Poor job offensively. I'm coaching. He's sitting next to me as an assistant coach. He's pounding the ball in the deck. Where's he going?
Tries for two, and in and out.
Nice job to create the angle and use the glass.
Gave it up. Goes for the deep one. Way off target. They're working around the arc. From three-point range. Off the rim and no good. Picks off the pass. Number three is feeling great out there right now.
And you know what, Brad? I'm excited for him. He's putting on a performance.
Move with a face up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves. He didn't have the good angle. They should have got it to him about a second earlier.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart. Great shot block right there. And some good movement on the offensive side.
And off the mark. Shot clock is dead. Looking for a good shot.
Great defensive play. Anticipated well. When you're an anticipator, you got a chance to do well. A lot of guys, they're reactors. If you're a reactor, you're one step behind the action.
Got an open look if he wants it. Controlling the ball. Trying to draw some contact. Number four makes the finger roll. And the ball goes out of play. Oh, that's going to be a costly turnover.
I'll tell you, turnovers can absolutely destroy a team.
With a deep shot from outside. Way off target. At the end of the first half, the Tigers trail by one. This one's too close to call here at the end of the first. Dick, do you have a highlight of the half?
My highlight, Brad, has to be the great work in the paint so far. It'll be interesting to see who keeps it up in the next half.
Let's get back down to the action where it looks like the two teams are all set to start the second half. Princeton has been giving up the ball like it's worth nothing.
Yeah, Brad, I don't know if I've ever seen a team turning over the ball like this. They're basically telling their opponents to keep attacking them.
Well, Dick, we kind of expected that battle between David and Goliath, and that's what we saw in the first half. What do you expect in the second half?
Well, I'll tell you what, in the second half, I expect them to really do a better job, the underdog, of protecting the basketball. I think they got to do a better job because at the end of the first half, they started to really get away from the things they did early.
Takes away the pass. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Good job defensively. They just won't get many openings.
Pressure in the basketball.
He up fakes. There's a nice block from behind, Dick.
Yeah, that's good timing for the defense.
And there's a look at the backcourt comparison, Dick.
Okay, Brad, you always want to know how the primary ball handlers are doing. Are they getting their team's quality shots? Good.
Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
The ball goes out of bounds.
Yeah.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside outside action always works.
He tries the three. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
I don't think the coach wants him taking that shot.
They work the perimeter. The small forward takes the pass. He shoots from the baseline. He's got to pass those off, Dick.
He doesn't trust his teammates, Brad.
Moving it around the perimeter.
There's the trap.
Off the rim and no good. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
This whole team that's on the floor is quick. But so's the defense, and they do a nice job. Turnaround jumper. Dick, he's in a serious rhythm.
Hey, that's because he's getting the ball in rhythm, Brad.
Very important.
Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
He makes a nice shot fake. Puts it on the floor and up and under. And he missed.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
A high screen. He lets it fly. Missed it. Decided against the open post and reverses the ball. That's an ill-advised shot.
That shot was definitely ill-advised.
The shooting guard takes the feed. Pull-up jumper from way out.
Man, he lured the defender to the screen, giving him time to shoot the sweet J.
On the dribble, gives it up. Number 41 draws the personal. And he's going to pick up the foul, and oh, look at the look on his face.
I'll tell you what, he's disgusted, but so is his coach.
Number 41 goes to the charity stripe for two. First shot, good. Foul shot, no good. Aggressively grabs the ball.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. Nice steal there, but the offense gets the ball back. Goes up for two. In and out. From the top of the circle. Off the rim and no good. He can't shake the pressure.
Has the screen up on top. He's just not giving the effort on defense.
He's not putting up a good fight at all. He missed the guy in the post and goes the other way. Takes the pass in the paint. Finger roll. Number 34 takes the pass in the paint. Goes up strong, but that's an offensive foul.
What a terrific job on the defense to beat him in the spot, Mr. Nessler.
They'd like to get it inside to the low block. Unable to so far. Nice job of packing it in defensively.
Yeah, really doing a great job packing it in. Did a great job of anticipating that lateral pass.
Dumps it in. Up fake. He attempts a jump hook. Doesn't go. For two.
Great play to take that to the basket.
fronts him first, Dick, and then works behind.
Yeah, he's playing from behind him because that tells me right there they don't respect him as an offensive player. And they made an error, obviously. But they don't have the great respect, so they're saying, you know what? Let him get the ball and let him try to beat us.
The center with the ball. That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that.
I tell you, they did a great job scouting post play because they were really anticipating the spin.
They go inside and now back outside.
I tell you, inside-outside action always works.
The center gets the pass. He beats him to the punch defensively.
What a terrific job. Footwork really excellent on a post player.
Puts it up, looking for contact. In the paint. A little bit of a collision there, but no foul called there.
I think a good call by the official. Not blowing a whistle. I think it's an excellent call.
Dick, how's he working him defensively?
I tell you, he's trying to front right now. You got three concepts. You can play halfway, you can play behind, or in front. They've decided to play in front, which means you got to get help side.
Number 55 sees his first action of the day.
Man, I love to watch this kid play, Brad. He's the type of player who knows how to really lift the team.
First one, good. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Guys, the underdogs are playing with a nothing-to-lose mentality tonight. They're shouting on the bench, let's leave it out on the floor. We've got an upset in the making.
Thanks, Aaron. Executes the baby hook. They still don't score. Goes up for two. He's taking his team out of the game plan with these shots, Dick.
Yeah, and even if you were hitting them, Brad, they're still bad shots.
For two, sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
Well, Brad and Dick, I don't know if you can hear it, but I can hear it clearly down here. The coach is stressing, go inside, go inside. They've been affected all night long that way. What an asset to have, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron.
Oh, I don't think there's any doubt about it, Brad. We've said so many times, you know, great post play, you got a chance really to win.
Look out, he's in the face of the opposition.
I don't know if all of that is necessary, Brad.
Number 45 to the line, shooting two. Hits the first. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Hits that one. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch. I tell you, he missed the post guy. The post guy had the great angle, was locking on a box.
Rims out. He keeps the concentration off the contact for the score. Intercepted. Pump fakes. Here's the toss back out from the post.
I tell you, coach's dream when your post player can be an exceptional passer.
The small forward gets the ball. He attempts the trifecta. He drains it. Entry pass in the paint, and now they'll bring it up. He gets the rejection. On the outside. On the inside. He scores it, and he's fouled. So an and one opportunity here. Look at him now, just enjoying the moment.
I love the zest of the young man. Dancing with the cheerleaders, that's awesome, Brad.
The Tigers are going to be at the line for the first time in this game. He missed it. Hickey's going to kick it back out there from down on the low block.
I tell you, a post player has to be able to read what the defense gives you.
Ball comes back out from the post.
I tell you, Brad, you got to have a post player that anticipates and knows how to find the open man.
He can't get the Jay to go despite running off the nice screen.
Takes away the pass. Tries to get the D to bite. And they come with a double team to stop it. He gets the board. Picks off the lazy pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Gave it up. Three. He gets the shot to fall. Picks off the pass. For the deuce. Tries for two. Perfectly executed. On the dribble, gives it up. He intercepts it. Number three. It's good. He took a midair whacking, but he got the layup to fall.
Hey, Brad, he deserves a free one for that play.
He'll go to the line. Just like in practice. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
The offense gaining great post position down low.
Absolutely. Getting the good inside angle. A poor job defensively. No help. I mean, that is post play at its best.
Gave it up. Has a nice look at the basket. For two. Drops the bucket despite the harm. Working around the perimeter. Got a nice screen. He puts it in with contact and all.
Man, I'm afraid to hear this crowd. If they can get a stop of this possession.
That spin move's not going to work against a defense like that. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Takes the pass in the paint. Try to stay with him defensively. Down he goes.
Oh, what an acting job. There's no doubt in my mind he's flopping, baby.
In the paint.
Very soft defensively. No pressure on a basketball.
And with that, there's going to be some open jumpers if they don't pick up defensively. If they can get a basket here, Dick, this crowd will erupt. And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Worked the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Looking for a good shot. He takes the shot from the baseline. He buries it. He launches the bomb. Off the rim and no good.
Dump it inside.
Way out on top. Controlling the ball. Sweet looking shot.
He is super. He really is.
It up using his size with a power move.
Oh, what a power goal. Jump stop, takes the ball to the goal strong.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
Gave it up. Nice move with a face-up.
I tell you one thing, Brad. I like guys that are versatile in that post. Facing up is a way to take advantage of three basic moves.
Picked out of the air. That spin move not successful, Dick.
I tell you, great job on the defense not allowing him to make that turn.
On the dribble, gives it up. He makes the block. So timeout on the floor, and that gives us a break to go courtside. Here's Aaron.
Brad and Dick, with limited time remaining, the coaches will have to figure out their offensive and defensive strategies for the next few possessions. What they will discuss or fail to discuss during this timeout could be the difference, guys.
All right, thanks, Aaron. It'll be interesting to see the level of energy, Dick, when they come out of this timeout. It's down to a one-point game, Dick.
Yes, sir. This is where the big boys start to play, Brad.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
And the ball goes out of bounds. And again, let's take a look at that State Farm drive of the game, Dick.
Hey, the ability to get to the paint is one thing, Brad, but he also demonstrated the ability to finish as well. That's awesome, baby, with a capital A.
That bucket cuts the lead to one.
I tell you, there was a lot of time, Brad.
Gave it up. He shoots from the top of the circle. Rims out. Tries the turn, and the defense comes up with a play.
What a terrific play.
And has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The ball goes out of play. There's a look at the timeout situation.
Hey, some people like to call it game management, Brad. Knowing when to use timeouts is an art. Also, team fouls. Defending without fouling is always important. Foul them early and give your team a chance.
I gotta be sure they'll continue to look to foul here, Dick.
Coaches love it when their team gets to the free throw line. It's an opportunity to put points on the board and potentially get the opponent in foul trouble.
Makes his second shot. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Looks like we're ready to step back out onto the court. They shave the lead down to three.
There's a lot of time to pull this one out, Brad.
On the outside. Picked off. And they continue to foul to stop the clock. And we'll go to the free throw line. Makes the front end of the 1-1. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Misses the second.
They need points on this possession, baby.
He makes the shot. Wow, man, that stops the clock again. As we see the game situation here.
Hey, Brad, these are elements of the game which coaches are really responsible for. Calling timeouts at the right time, knowing which way the possession arrow is pointing. All factors that are important in close games.
Gets the second shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
just about ready for play to resume. 3 points is the difference.
That's right, so somebody better guard the York.
Now the high screen. He puts it up at the horn. Misses from long range. Princeton will not walk away with a win tonight as they lose this close one.
You know, they really showed what they were made of and can come away from this game with a moral victory.
So for Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.